production would have been better in the end, it looks like. Unit's already attacked, I believe. So we don't mind if we put it somewhere to die. Love how he thinks this is teaming. This is literally him forcing me to do this. I even gave him peace after that stupid artillery push that failed of his. Because I'm like, I might still be relevant to this game if I can just have some peace. So he attacks.
I know.
Not, he attacks 11 turns later. You know, like as soon as the peace deal is up. And I don't know what he expects me to do. Just let him do this without retaliating. I have about zero sympathy for him here. All right. Zero sympathy. Well, I'm not playing for the win right now. I'm playing for the fact that I have no win option. All my win options have been removed from me by this player. So, like, all I'm doing at this stage is just prolonging. Prolonging how long it takes him to kill me to make him hurt as much as possible for killing my game like this. Come on, promotion, let me actually fucking assign heals. But again, I have a million hours of experience with stealth bomber fights, right? We've done this, been here. Where? Oh, that infantry. No one gives a fuck about that infantry. Maybe we can get two more nukes off, maybe not. Before we die.
He just traded more than armor for his skull.
Let's go. Ooh, nice. Too bad I have my guys all over there already. Can you kill that that tank? The modern armor?
No. City State was supposed to do that, but...
Oh, it's my modern armor. Never mind. We're good. I thought it was his modern armor. Didn't think I got the kill on that unit, but I did. I don't know why. The red and red, I guess.
Returned.
All right. Welcome back, Naz. Nazir, I guess. Thank you very much for the resub. I really hope Civ 6 boosts my channel too, man. That'd be great for me. I guess I'm gonna go there, upgrade. Try. I mean, rocket artillery aren't very good versus XCOM, which is why I haven't been bothering with them. But I'm running out of blocker units in the city, and I don't think I'm gonna get 3 turns. Really don't think that. I'm gonna nuke both my allies if I nuke there. Because this unit's in the way and that unit's not quite there. I think I'm gonna rebase here and nuke these two cities, kill the rest of his production. Get a couple more stealth bombers. Take me an extra turn to do it, but I have that extra turn. If I lose my cap, I don't have to leave. I can just nuke him still. I don't really care about the rocket artillery. I don't know, maybe I do. Maybe I just want to deny him any chance of getting a victory here. I don't know, he's kind of in my own troops here. No, fuck it, we're going to nuke his other city. Alright, right there, next turn. Okay. I don't see any immediate holes. Backed off of that for some reason. Awesome. Get another unit in there. That's rough terrain, so if I do choose to cycle out, there's no open terrain openings here. So. Okay. Cycle units in between. Another blocker unit there, still totally surrounded. Netherlands dead. Can't poke him. Alright, 2 turns on this nuclear missile. Alright. Oh, Bob's definitely gonna win. He's 100% of going to have won from this guy refused to fucking stop attacking me. It's Babylon in the late game, and he's just terrified about what I'm gonna do. Moved all of his units away from the citadel, so he can't kill that. Well, he might be able to kill that unit.
Can you purchase another defensive movement?
No, I don't have any money.
I mean, do you have the possibility?
Oh yeah, I mean, I only have walls in there, so I could get a castle, for example. I don't really think that's necessary, though.
Well, you can decline then.
No, I'll definitely take it. I think I should just purchase another AA gun. I think it's better.
Probably, yes.
I'm 152 gold off that, though. I guess I could sell labs. Hold on. There's a unit next to my cap now. I will buy that armor, that castle. Alright, did you get the road? Got the road. Too bad. Okay. Another nuke. I'm gonna nuke myself here. I think right on there. Maybe all of his XCOM. I can nuke all of his XCOM too. Really low on units here. Oh, I shouldn't have taken that one. That one is covered by zone of control off the river. Not gonna have a lot of time to think about where this next nuke goes. I get a nuke next turn. I need cash for another defensive building. It's going to be a lot, though. 465.
How much?
Hold on, I might be able to sell. I sell labs still. 50 gold, 60 gold in the factory. I'll get it. I'll have enough when I sell all my shit. Oh, factories are happiness, damn. Still 100 gold short. Delete workers. Thanks. Almost done, Zach. Yep. Vote against his Lux. Start a nuclear missile here. It's not going to be 8 turns, so that city goes, but... Ooh, we can start in the other city, though. Maybe just keep getting AAs. Okay. 5, that's halfway reasonable. Shouldn't have sold the factory, should have sold the public school there. Wasn't thinking about the happiness element of it. Alright, Mobile Sam. Just do an XCOM. Where are we? Where is this unit? There. Normally you're doing, when you're doing this in a stealth war, stealth bomber versus stealth bomber, you actually have stealth of your own to help protect it. I don't right now. I don't want him here. I'm gonna nuke right on top of my own capital here if I can. Unless I get fucked by this. Come on! There we go.
Did you nuke yourself?
I deliberately nuked myself there so he couldn't capture the city this turn. Mm-hmm. And I killed all his units around there. It didn't let me nuke directly on my capital. I had to nuke one tile over. Which sucks, because it means there's a couple left.
You cannot.
I didn't know I couldn't nuke directly on my own city. He thinks it's on accident. I did it to kill all of his fucking units. Okay. Alright. To reset that. Maybe can we sell walls? I don't think we can sell walls. Alright. Still got my fighter. Okay. Alright, what do we build here? Guided missile? Yeah! Maybe we can guided missile the arc rocket artillery. Ignore them, Bob. You're about to win the game. Don't even fucking talk to this idiot. You're about to win the game. You're going to win a game from his direct fucked up actions here. Like, his misplays here are going to win you the game, which is awesome for you.
I mean, that happens all the time when people, like, they don't realize, like, when there are an opponent, there are two opponents who are, like, more or less the only contestants to the victory besides myself. Of course they're going to help the other guy defend and, like, still made the war. It's
of course.
Fucking obvious.
It makes the most sense ever. I know. And it's the same with this guy. Like, he's like, after he's made me invest all the resources in defending him, I mean, even that last time with the artillery one, right? Which almost killed me, right? Almost lost cities to the artillery one. Switched over everything. It delays all my shit. I'm like, I still accept peace. I'm like, I still maybe have a chance. And then he wars me 10 turns later again. If he's just going to war me every single time he hits another military tech, why would I ever peace him? I'll just drag him down into a loss as well. Like, if he's gonna do that to my game, why the fuck would I not do it back to his game? Just painful. See, I don't, and he doesn't understand it at all. He's acting like, I don't want you to win, I wanted to win. But if I have no chance of winning because this guy is warring me and won't stop warring me, I'm not going to just ask for a relevancy and give him my lands. Fuck that. I don't know. If he doesn't get it, I can't explain it to him better than this. Can we shoot? Oh, we could go there. Okay. Might have made to recapture this city. Where's my rocket artillery? Did it die? No, it didn't. I will let him take the cap. Alright, I've nuked 4 of his cities and he's gonna die to Bob. Good. Exactly, the player is used to playing bad players. That's exactly what it is. The lobby's too good for him. Like, he played well. He played very well in the sense of he got really good infrastructure, really good science, took a lot of land. He's in a dominant position for the late game and just chose not to win. That's what I wanted him to do. Is this a road here? No. No road there, though. I can't double capture then. Okay. So we need to wait for a second. Is his cap gone yet? Gone in a second. Okay. Alright, and then... Yeah, the cap was always named irrelevant. Vote me, please. Yeah, I'm not saying he's a bad player. I'm not saying he... I mean, I honestly think the push with the artillery push was a really good timing push for him. And I think it was super smart of him to ask for peace when that didn't work. Right? Like, he doesn't want to run into an irrelevant war. And I kind of respected that play. And I respected that play enough that I'm like, all right, I'm annoyed with him for attacking me. It's costing me shit. But I'll still give him peace. There's a chance I can come back from this. And it's a really smart play on his part, right? Okay. The turnaround, though, is he just does it again 10 turns later. I can recapture my capital whenever. I'm just trying to decide whether or not...
I think Kel's going to nuke me.
Okay. Which part of you is he going to nuke? You have like 20,000 cities.
Yeah, I suppose my army...
Yeah, that's what he's saying, Pazuzu, and that's why I really don't like. All right.
In fact, he has 2 nukes.
Will you kick him, please? Oh, you're not host. Who's host?
I'm not the host. Celt.
I'm gonna take my capital back and I'm gonna piece him and I'm gonna end the game with my fucking capital and he's not. G fucking G. Fantastic. All right. Comeback time. Yep. I can only imagine this city will be amazing. Let's get a stele. Kind of looks like a middle finger right now, which is how I'm feeling. So... So let's do it. Okay. Some workers. All right. Man, I didn't even think Poland could lose this game. I was a little bit worried. I mean, I knew your science was going to be amazing late game, but his hammers plus his science, I just assumed he would crush anyone by going to space whenever he wanted, faster than anybody could stop him. I don't understand why he felt it necessary to just attack into me until he lost himself the game. Why? Why would he do it?
Well, reasonability is not the quality of NQ group, so...
Ugh. I nuked myself deliberately to delay the amount of time it takes. It killed all the units to be able to capture my city. And killed his entire units. I already nuked both the cities I could reach. All four of the cities I could reach. So I killed all of his infrastructure, all of his units in there, everything I could do there. And then it was just to kill all of his units. So kill his hammers for potential further fighting and kill all of his existing units. And what happens? As soon as he loses his capital, he leaves the game because he's fucked. So... It's gonna be a concede Bob next turn. How do you protect against nukes? You can't protect against nukes. Nukes are one of, just like you can't really protect against stealth bombers, they're one of the final ways the game ends. If it goes down to domination, they're one of the final ways that games end. So the thing is about nukes, you know, nukes are production. They're very, very, very expensive production-wise. And most of the time, once you're to a point where you're nuking into bomb shelters or something like that, it's better to spend your production elsewhere. So by the time someone can build a bunch of nukes, most of the time someone else could have gone to space already. So. Ugh. Bomb shelters are later, and bomb shelters don't protect you, because bomb shelter protects you from 75% of the population death or something like that in your capital, right? Or the city you build it. But you still lose all your units surrounding it, and it still does 50% damage to the
thing.
GG, Bob. Yeah, I feel like the Celts were semi-irrelevant. It doesn't look like the Netherlands put up a fight. America was definitely...
I kind of knew it would come to this. My start was horrible. I made so many crucial mistakes, but I knew you would like end up in a fight with Poland, so I was kind of banking on that. So,
well, as I was saying at one point in the game, I'm like, it's an impossible situation. Babylon is going to have a much better science game at the end, because Babylon always has the best science game in the end, which means that my immediate neighbor, though, has production, a standing army, has gone honor instead of rationalism, and is aggressively expanding everywhere. Of course he's going to fucking attack.
Yeah, the honor, I didn't get that. He could just go into rationalism.
I know. Why would he bother with honor? Okay, so maybe he wants to take a couple of city-states. Fine, he doesn't need honor to take city-states. You know, like, he could have just grabbed those three city-states that he took without honor and been just fine. Why the fuck didn't he go rationalism till the... I mean, his science was so good without rationalism. Imagine how good his science would have been with rationalism.
Yeah, I know.
It's disgusting. All right, chat. That was an interesting game. Different ending. GG, Duragon. Different ending than perhaps we've had in a while. It was a domination victory from Bob. So I'm going to take a quick break, run some ads. I'll be back in 60 seconds. I'm not going to be back in 60 seconds. I'm going to run some ads. I'll be back in a few minutes. I figure out what's going on next. So I'll see you guys shortly.